Thank you, Mr. Chair. Thank you, panelists. I think I just heard, I'm not sure which of you might have said, the young lady in the front, that we don't have a right under the Second Amendment to build our own guns. Is that your position?
I think that's correct, yes.
Okay, so from the founding of our country, when the right was first established, was first recognized in the Constitution under the Second Amendment, we've been building our guns. And that's how we won the first, as you heard me in my opening, you know, my opening question, that was how we won the revolution. So I think it also goes to betray your potential motive here, because the other gentleman just said that that would not be forbidden, that this bill's intent wasn't to do what you just said, was to prevent a right that we've had since the inception of our country. But let me get to the question, though, that the gentleman posed, and that is, without a serial number, you can still build your kit, but you got to have a serial number. And that's what I heard you say.
Yes.
But that's the whole idea of a ghost gun and the whole idea of a serial number making us safer is an entire myth. Isn't that true?
No, I don't think it is a myth.
Well, here's why. It doesn't matter. A criminal can still use a gun to do crimes with, correct? Whether it has a serial number or not.
That's absolutely true. The difference, I think, is that this legislation will allow law enforcement to address this problem at the supply level. So the entities selling online the kits to create firearms, they're able to address those. So this isn't a question of it's that ability to go after the hot top of the supply chain that makes this legislation effective in addressing the ghost gun problem. So it may be the case that somebody cannot create in their home from scratch and then sell a firearm, but that's much more difficult to do than to purchase one of these kits online and then to do it. Process of putting together a firearm using one of these kits for somebody without any special expertise, you can do this in an hour or two. Really not very difficult at all.
And I like to do it with my sons. I mean, this is part of our tradition. And yet it's still a false narrative because there is no gun database in this country. There's no way to trace anything other than the first point of sale. That's all you can do. So this whole discussion is pointless.
I would agree that the way the tracing system is set up is such that you're able to trace the gun at the first point of sale. The problem is that these ghost guns circumvent that, and this legislation is an effort to bring them back into that system.
Well, I think that's severely misguided, particularly considering the testimony that the young lady mentioned, that she thinks that it's not even part of our fundamental right. So, but with that, I yield.